summer of 83-84, which was my summer between my sophomore and junior year at Carolina, a group of us were spending the summer in Chapel Hill, and as we were watching Village Cable, what is now Carolina Cable, we turned to the University Access Channel, Channel 11, and saw this blank slate. All it said was, "This is the University Access Channel." And we started to think to ourselves, you know, that seems like a waste of an opportunity. Why don't we, you know, and we started dreaming up all these ideas for television shows.
Hello, I'm Bill Shaw, your host for STV Presents. This is a pilot show for a series written and produced entirely by students at the University of North Carolina in Chapel Hill.
The Department of RTVMP was very, very supportive of student television. Richard Simpson, the faculty advisor, was extremely helpful. They let us use some of their equipment to produce a pilot show, which we did and which got a very, very good response. It was interesting. None of us had ever really had any production experience, those of us who had conceived of the show. But then we got some RTVMP students to actually manipulate the cameras and do the lighting and things like that for us. So we had one half of the production crew who had no idea what they were doing but just had all these ideas, and then the other half who, I'm not saying they didn't have ideas, but they definitely had the technical skills from either professional work or from RTVMP.
Hello, troops. Welcome to Student Television's premiere segment tonight. We've got a lot of good footage tonight. I didn't say my name. Did I?
We had no idea what we were doing, and you can tell by looking at our stuff. I think we had great ideas of what to do, like what subjects needed to be covered, etc. But we really had no idea how to use the cameras, and so it was very much trial and error. Originally, we had one edit bench and still just as many great ideas. And in order to cram them all onto one poor editing bench and one camera, it required that that equipment be humming 24 hours a day. We used to wedge shoes in the security doors of the union and, of course, get in real trouble for that, at which we didn't mean any offense, but, you know, there the equipment was. We needed to have access to it. And I think that that's a realistic expectation, because in the video and television, in the film and video industry, editing is a late night process. You know, sure, you try to squeeze it in between 9 and 5, but that never happens. There's what's called a night shift at most post-production facilities. And so that's the real world, and I think that STV's members should continue to edit all night long. That's when some of the greatest ideas come along.
The most valuable tools we have at STV.
Bien?
Yeah. Oh my God. I must be mad.
You must be mad.
No, it's fun. It is. Despite the headaches and sleepless nights and everything like that, it's still fun.
And the
it's rewarding on Monday night when you see the show and it's up there and you're saying, not bad.
Got involved in STV by winning the David Letterman Look and Act Alike contest, which was sponsored by a show which used to be called This Is It, but is now called Off the Cuff. I won the contest, and I did a show for STV, and then I became the producer of This Is It.
And now, our next guest, Carol Channing, a real treat to this show, a legend in her own time, star of stage, screen, and The Morning Show. Come on, Carol.
Oh my, I'm really here.
Are you sure you're really here, Carol?
The early days of Off the Cuff were a heady mix of wild humor and insightful social commentary, like when we had the Andy Warhol talking wig, or when we had the Hey Stevie song, trying to get Stevie Nicks to lose a little bit of her tonnage, which unfortunately she doesn't seem to have done.
A side of beef? Stevie, please. How about trying some cottage cheese?
Hey, Stevie. Hey, Stevie.
Steve, your buttocks grow and grow. When you see junk food, just say no.
I guess I started in my second semester, my freshman year, although I didn't really do anything. I was kind of a dweeb and just hung around and did nothing. Until finally I started getting involved, I guess, my sophomore year, and I actually went on a shoot, imagine that, and then I kind of got sucked in from there and started doing more and more stuff, which is kind of how STV works. So I think other people probably get sucked in quicker. But I got, so eventually, until finally I worked my way up to assistant producer and producer and then director of operations, which is a wonderful title. Looks great on a resume.
What did you enjoy doing the most?
That's tough. That's a tough question. Well, there was making Davy the bar of soap.
Well, the most memorable skit was the one that T. Mike wrote about the Coaxed. I mean, I think that is like my signature skit as far as STV goes.
Two Suns Great Coaxed. I'll try it. Smells refreshing. Yeah, I like it.
General College began as a segment on Off the Cuff. I was an assistant producer at the time, and I was looking for an idea that could be a segment that would run weekly that I could shoot at the beginning of the semester and then pretty much just edit it as the semester went along, and it'd be just one part of Off the Cuff. Once it started, after the first episode, its popularity grew so much that by the next week, I was given my own show.
General College did begin on Off the Cuff. It was actually on the very second Off the Cuff. And then it quickly was spun off because it wasn't funny. We thought that General College was going to be a spoof of soap operas, but it turned out not to be. And so Martin Clark, who was the station manager at that time, and I decided that it wasn't appropriate to have it on our show. Little did I know that they were going to spin it off and create the most successful program on STV out of it.
Watch NCTV every week for General College, the soap opera produced by students at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill.
Well, it's definitely a bonus because we get money from NCTV, and also people call from, like, I think it was the University of California at San Francisco, I believe, and somebody ran into somebody from that university and they said, oh, we've seen General College, or they recognized one of our actors, and that's nice because we couldn't have that with student television broadcasting on Caroline Cable. And also we get to compete, I guess, a little bit with national shows like University, which is the other soap opera, and all the shows on that. At least there's some different competition than from around here.
This is like one of the best things that could have happened to my acting career in college. Because, I mean, you do plays or whatever, and people see them, but it's the people in the university, students and faculty. But being on national television has given us a lot of exposure, not only to, like, newspapers, like the Los Angeles Times and the New York Times and all North Carolina papers, but it's given us exposure to, and I know, like, some producers in California supposedly watch it, and it's just given us a lot of exposure, and it's a great thing to say, you know, I've done the show in student television or whatever, but it's even more impressive to say, you know, I was on a nationally syndicated soap opera.
It's gotten a lot better. I mean, at the beginning, technically, it was, you couldn't hear anything, and you couldn't, the footage was just not too great. But now the footage, I think, is a lot more professional looking. We've not mastered lighting, but we've gotten a whole lot better at lighting. So we can even have mood lighting and colors and all kinds of neat stuff. And the writing has gotten a lot better. When they first started, they didn't even have scripts. They go on a shoot and just kind of ad-lib and go with the general idea of what they wanted to do. And now that it's scripted and we try to have some complex storylines, some complex characters, and make the show well-rounded.
It's a lot more challenging. It's easy. It's not easy, but it's easier to play somebody who's nice. And it's kind of, you know, it's a nice, perfect person But playing somebody who's more complex is a lot more challenging. It's a lot more interesting to do for me.
I made a decision. I'm going back to dance. And if I'm going to do that, then I don't need to be eating burgers.
What do you mean going back to dance? I thought you were only on the squad for a little while before you quit to do the show.
Well, I was. But I just didn't have time to do both. And dance is what I've always really loved, you know that. So now I'm going back to it, which is why I don't need to be eating grilled burgers tonight. So will you please get dressed? I don't want to be too late.
Why don't we just eat dinner here?
The best examples, Billy plays, play Jason, I play Scott. I don't even think wanted to act when he first came to Carolina, and now that's what he wants to do for his career, and he's much, much, much better actor than, at least on Junior College, than he was when he first came in. A lot of the actors, yeah, definitely they mature. It is something you learn, especially if they've done stage. They learn how to act for the camera. They learn how to make their face do a certain thing for a certain scene. Oh, sure, it definitely is a case between their first shoot and their 18th shoot. But I don't think after a certain point you get comfortable with the camera. It's not a big deal anymore. And the shoots aren't real high pressure. They're basically relaxed. I don't think the actors feel this great pressure to perform perfection. You know, maybe they should.
Watch General College all this week, only on NCTV. For students, by students.
Magazine format came because we have so many people that want to be on the show. And Alex Burnett was the producer last semester, and he's like, well, what are we going to do with all these people because we don't need them? I said, well, if we do a PM Magazine type format, we can do more features and not the news. And I think that's what we've been working at. I think it's easier because we do have a lot of people knocking on the doors. I want to report. I want to do this. And it's made it a little bit easier. It's been tough because you do have more people. But I think we've gone away from the news because the time when Monday rolls around, all this stuff is a week old. And people's like, well, I knew that last week. So that's why we're taking more featurey type things that's not as timely. It doesn't get old. And I think it's worked a lot better. Welcome to Campus Profile. I'm Lee Powell.
And I'm Scott Cooper. Tonight we'll take a look at tryouts for UNC's dance team, the High Kicking Heels. And we'll also take a look at the housing situation for students in Chapel Hill.
Tonight we'll be taking a look at some tutoring programs that are sponsored by student government. And we'll also take a look back to the walkathon to benefit Tina Levy.
Tonight we'll take a look at the Black Cultural Center's efforts to find a permanent home. And we'll also take a look back at AIDS Awareness Week.
Tonight we'll examine the parking situation in Chapel Hill and just how bad that's become.
And with spring break just around the corner, we're going to find out what some of you students are going to do with that 1 week of vacation. Especially now in the 90s, we've done a lot of stuff on AIDS Awareness Week. I'm kind of partial. I've done a lot on rape, and I think that rape needs to be heard here on campus. People need to be aware, so we've done a lot of special series on that. We've done feature things like the Clefhangers, some singing groups on campus, just to let people know what's out there, what they can do, you know, that type of thing. But I think, like, AIDS would probably be the most timely that we've been able to cover about how to be aware, safe sex, that type of thing.
Carolina campus is always a busy place, and February 12th to 17th was no exception. AIDS Awareness Week, sponsored by many student organizations, consisted of daily programs to educate students about AIDS. Andy Ward, chairman of the committee, said there were a variety of scheduled events.
Good evening and welcome to the Student Body Presidential Forum. I'm your host, Lee Powell. Tonight, all the candidates for Student Body President will be speaking. We're going to start out with Mark Bibbs, who would like to introduce himself now.
Thank you, Lee. My name is Mark Bibbs, and I'm running for Student Body President.
You know, of course, I want to sit here and say, oh, my show's great, but I think you have to look back on the time period, you know, and I think that probably 10 years from now, I'm going to look at these shows and like, I mean, the next person, me too, but the next person, they would go, oh, that was just awful. And I mean, you know, at the time, I think my show's great, but I think it's just the time and how much you know.
The advantage is for those who can't make it to the show live, because the show, you know, it's a joint thing with the Carolina Union Activities Board. And so the advantage is for those who can't make it to the show Wednesdays at noon, they can have an outlet where they can watch, you know, on student television. They can watch and see what their favorite campus personality got to say when they're on midday. And also, I just think it's a, it fills a neat little niche here at Carolina. You know, we've got our own little talk show, we've got our own soap opera, our own comedy show, our own news show.
Can I ask you, do you like Chancellor Hurd?
Sure do. He's a good golfer too.
Good golfer.
You bet.
No controversy tonight, folks. Today. Well, let's see. First of all, hey, did you guys know that Time Out serves spaghetti now?
We've got business people. We've got me advertising. We've got speech communication and drama. You know, we've got a lot of different people here. And yeah, that's an advantage. I mean, I'm an advertising major. I don't know what the furthest from RTVMP is per se, you know, if we've had a Russian major who's produced a show. But, you know, I think it's great that any student can come. I mean, this is truly student television.
Well, I think the most important thing that student television hopes to accomplish is to train students that are interested in gaining video production experience. Whether that be on the technical end, they want to edit or shoot, or whether they want to, some people are like drama majors, they want to get involved, they want to maybe act in a TV series, getting involved on the more creative side. I think that of late, we have found ourselves a lot more involved in helping other student organizations through video production services. And I think that's going to become a much more important part of the organization than it has been in the past. We helped the Student Environmental Action Coalition out with Threshold, which was a national student environmental conference. We teleconferenced it. We shot everything live from Memorial Hall and teleconferenced it to other areas on campus because there was an overflow crowd. We also helped the Padilla program. They had a conference, a statewide conference on teaching in North Carolina and how to input the Padilla program into the public schools. And we taped a conference online for them, and they've since asked for several copies of that tape.
Nothing else on campus that could possibly give you this experience. You couldn't learn how to do this stuff in class. You couldn't learn the most important thing, I think, which is troubleshooting, because a million things are wrong. Our equipment is not in the best of shape. It's not new. And so you have to learn how to deal with all this. There's no way that I could learn this anywhere else. You absolutely meant the needs.
I would have done this no matter what my major was, just because I enjoy it more than, it means more to me than just putting it on a resume, although I think it's excellent practical experience. I mean, because you're really down and up to your armpits in it, you know, slogging away, you know, hauling equipment around, you know, working under bad conditions and you know, desperately under a weekly deadline. You know, I think this is all stuff that'll serve everyone in good stead.
It's people who want to act, but they also want to know more about directing, editing, writing, just little things like tech people or doing costumes or whatever. You have the opportunity. Nobody's going to force you to do it, and there's nobody who's going to say, no, you can't do this. Nobody. I mean, STV is a great way to get involved in every aspect of television.
If you're, you know, really ready to get into it and want to get involved with every aspect, then definitely. It's the best learning experience at UNC, I think. It's a hands-on, it's completely student-run, it's fantastic.
You know, I get disappointed in people and in things that happen, and I think everyone does, but you have to learn to take those things with a grain of salt. You know, we're all human, and things aren't always going to work out for the best. You just have to make the best of them.
I think that STV, in my completely unbiased opinion, is the most wonderful thing that's ever happened at Carolina. To be a little more objective about that, I see STV continuing to grow in the exact same rate that it's growing, but I think it needs to be careful, because just as when I was a student producer at STV, you tend to put blinders on. You tend to think the most important thing is that deadline for that show that's got to go on the air. But I think the most important thing is the organization itself.
Hello, I'm Charles Carroll. Of course, when I'm on the road in Chapel Hill, I watch STV, UNC Student Television.